Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. After multiple delays, the Ax1 space mission with private astronauts Ax1 was pushed back a tad bit more. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the Ax1 mission is expected to lift off on Friday 8th at 3:17pm UTC or 11:17pm EDT. SpaceX posted a tweet about the Falcon 9 and Dragon for the Ax1 mission, which are now vertical on pad LC-39A. Forto would share this tweet posted with a video of SpaceX's recovery vessel Bob carrying two intact fairings from the Transporter 4 mission. SpaceX posted a tweet about the launch that will come after the Ax1 mission lifts off, NROL 85. They said, static fire test of Falcon 9 complete, targeting Friday, April 15th for launch of the NROL 85 mission from Vandenberg in California. The Falcon 9 first stage supporting this mission previously launched NROL 87 in February. There was another interesting article posted related to science that is planned for the Ax1 mission. It says, this week, four SpaceX crew members will conduct the first ever experiments on cultivated meat in space. The historic Axiom 1 mission is the first fully private spaceflight to the International Space Station, and among other experiments will test the effects of microgravity on the formation of muscle tissue cultivated by LF farms. There is an article about another launch that SpaceX has secured. It says, Astranis Space Technologies has signed a contract with SpaceX for a dedicated Falcon 9 launch to put four Astranis Micro Geo Communications satellites into service in 2023. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site with Booster 7 on the orbital mount. The Starship Quick Disconnect has been removed from the tower QD arm. The Booster Quick Disconnect on the orbital mount is attached to Booster 7. This bridge crane was seen lifted into the wide bay to be installed. Multiple bridge cranes are now installed in the wide bay. Everyday Astronaut posted a tweet saying, anyone have a good source on the weight output of the Tesla Model S plaid motor? In this section, we are showing why electric turbopumps don't scale up well. Based on these potentially inaccurate numbers, it would take approximately 676 motors just to spin the pumps of an RD-170. Musk responded with, Raptor pump power is over 100 megawatts per engine and 33 engines means over 3 gigawatts. Not even remotely possible for electric motors and batteries to compete. The Starship 24 nose cone was once again rolled out of the fabrication tent. The Ship 24 aft section was seen being moved to the high bay for stacking. However, not for Starship 24 stacking, interestingly it was stacked atop Booster 8 but later removed. The liquid oxygen section of Ship 24 was moved into the high bay for stacking. On Monday, Super Heavy Booster 7 came to life as SpaceX did some testing. During the day, SpaceX did a full cryogenic proof test of the Booster 7 prototype. Look at this crazy venting as Booster 7 depressurized. Taking a brief look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website after the testing of Booster 7, all dates have been cancelled. As always, I have to say thank you to Mary or Boca Chica Girl as well as Nick Antuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.